I guess Fen could do some McLovin. I think should we play some ready or not tomorrow?
But is there any like actual new?
Not that I know of. Other than the development update. Kaka kaka kaka.
What can I help you with?
Where did I left off? Where did I left off? Ooh, that. Trash. Trashy trash. Ghost of pleasing, ghost of him. Do some more dungeons.
Okay, so I'm gonna read you something, a message. So are you going to stay for the 9 months, or are you still deciding? And she responds, depends if we are truly no longer a thing, and then I can pack up everything again, put it in storage, and he can break the lease with the deployment papers. And so she's still like basically not quite ready to leave until she's sure that their thing is over. Leaving the possibility that she might stay if they could somehow patch things up after this. The actual incident is that he said he didn't want to eat her special meal and like go sleep in a separate room, but like there's so much shit around it that she had a breakdown over it. But she's still like sort of leaving the option that if he's willing to make up or something, that she might stay the 9 months in Washington by herself if they're still going to be still together, essentially, like even while he's deployed and not together, like not in the same like space obviously, but like they're in a relationship. Well, but he's going to be going away on deployment. And I like wrote, the guy rented a 2-bedroom apartment just so he could wordlessly dump you while you're pregnant. That alone makes me think he's a fucking psycho.
And you went with this guy? Oh my god. Wouldn't she should have known from the beginning before she did all that?
So yeah, Hunter, well, hindsight's 2020, I guess.
It's like, okay, he's a freaking smoker. He freaking drinks. He's a freaking alcoholic.
He smokes. He's an alcoholic. He must certainly know that you don't like how she's told him that like she doesn't like how much he drinks, and she doesn't like it when he smokes or vapes and shit.
And yet, how did you not see all this happening before you got pregnant from him?
It's I don't know, it was a honeymoon period. Like he gave her a lot of attention and affection
for a short period of time.
Yeah, but that's I don't know that like that to be honest, that is actually why she talked to me. She actually did talk to me, is because I kept talking to her. You know, I showed her attention, and so she just responded to that. She's like going through a lot. Like there's a lot of shit that she's been going through even before this guy. So it doesn't. I don't know what she really seems like she needs, like, she like is looking for someone who is like gonna be supportive and caring, but like
for her new daughter,
or whoever. But it really seems like she's just kind of looking in the exact wrong places, for like the person, the type of guy she likes is guy in the army. You know what I mean? Like that. There's just like looking in the wrong places for someone who is actually going to be like, I don't know, be a good boyfriend or be attentive or being able to be around. And she gets like stuck on these people. And I don't know what it is. If it actually is her personality or it really is just like she just picks the wrong guy every single time. Like I don't know.
Oh, to be honest, meeting her in person was kind of awkward too.
I haven't met her in person.
Oh, it's her apartment.
She was meh.
Just buy some wireless headphones. Do you have any wireless headphones?
Yeah, I bought it for $149.50. 50% off in the base.
Nice.
It's the Bose.
Grab it while you one so I can I should get some wireless ones so I can actually go out in the kitchen and do stuff.
It connects via Bluetooth.
What the fuck? She's also like making him. The guy also seems to be like letting her or making her pay for like everything and also the rent in the apartment.
Oh my god, that's a bunch of bullshit right here. I'm pretty sure he gets money from signing up.
If you obviously get an enlistment bonus. Also, if he's living off post. Which it appears that he is. Because he's living with her. If he's living off post, then then he should be getting a housing stipend. Which Sarah got that, where you got some money to help pay rent.
Yeah, this guy's just ripping her off. I don't know. It just seems like she got completely manipulated or something. I don't know. It's weird. Maybe she can convince him to move back on base or something. That she has a, wouldn't that give her a place to stay while he's deployed?
It's her apartment. And she's paying for it. I guess she bought the second room for her kid. That is supposed to be the baby's room, right? But as I posted, he still said the bedroom thing. He still said that the bedroom thing, so like my point still stands. Also, how can he let you pay for everything?
I'll be right back.
All right.
See, it seems like that guy needs counseling. Maybe Ben can counsel. I think it's a good time for Fen to step up the plate and start dating this Nepeta.
he needs to be the he needs to become her platonic life partner and help raise her child.
Ew. Or maybe you can hook her up with Ven, because,
I pay for my car and $1,000 of the rent. He has to pay for something. Gas, food, utility bills. So I pay a rough amount. So I pay a rough amount of $3,000 monthly for bills, which is a grand for rent, a couple hundred, $735 for like just paying off her car, gas, utility, internet, storage.
Sucks.
Not including the paracord. Oh my god. Also, it just occurs to me that I don't know what kind of insurance she's getting. So, like, I don't know. Staying with this guy might like need like, I don't know if she actually. You know what? I don't know if she even gets TRICARE. I don't know if she actually gets military health care. Like, are they like common law married because she's pregnant with his kid? Like, I'm not really sure how that works. Like at what point do you get like or do you get to have the baby delivered in like a. At Madigan, basically.
I don't know. They're so stupid.
Are you talking right now? What'd I miss?
Nothing much. Oh yeah, we should play Ghost Watchers again.
Wait, you're talking right now?
What? I thought assume you really need.
No, it's like he's talking to her right now.
A lot of bad stuff happens to you, but it always makes me happy when you have it.
Still charging.
Feels good.
can't cast that yet. Let's do it. I'm out of range.
Try to pretend that
that spell is charging.
You'd be allowed to run around the yard. Chase the planes on the top.
I can't cast that yet.
That's what I'm saying. Sucks. Because you really seem to like your job at the start.
It sounds like Coach Reza is having a mental breakdown.
Alright.
Who's he talking to?
Probably her.
Oh, that was like, I thought I was talking to his dad or something.
Any potential FBI agents should be aware that this is a joke. And not a serious threat to the United States.
Nepeta is a serious threat to the United States.
Oh god, okay.
Jeez.
I'm still messaging Nepeta, so I've been kind of busy.
Sounds like you just scooped up a bunch of gravel and just poured it down my ear.
Wait, me?
Yeah, I don't know what that was.
He was trying to hide Nepeta's body? Okay, okay.
I'm really sorry. No, I said that I'm still talking to Nepeta, so that I've been away from the microphone and I should notice I plugged in a set of wired headphones to be the audio output, so it, none of my speakers bleed into my microphone like it usually does. So I just had my headphones off, so if you were saying anything or I
yeah, that thing. Just being,
No, we didn't say anything.
Been hearing fragments,
definitely was cool as a as ice.
Nice. Okay. Cool. I just make sure planes have beds to sleep in and get fed. Then I code and make sure people have a job. To the point where all the maintenance guys like me, all because of a captain with a foot up his ass. Lots of stories I have.
What?
She's talking like Yoda, folks. She's talking about her job.
Okay. I mean, you should hook her up with Fen, because, yeah.
No.
Carl does not want her in the group as a regular thing.
Ah.
He finds her.
She needs a place for a few days, maybe.
Well, I think it's right at this point. So talking to her. Here's some background. The guy apparently makes only gets paid $1,000 per month, is what the guy claims. So he makes 12,000 a year. So he makes no money. He technically lives in the barracks, but he's been living with her in her apartment. And she's been footing most of the rent because he makes no money. Now she's pregnant with his kid, I presume. I guess that is the case. But they're not married, so she doesn't get any of the kind of military benefits.
Oh, that's right.
So she doesn't even get any of the benefits of being with this guy because she's not even married to him. So when she ends up giving birth, she's gonna have to foot the whole ass bill for that, in a regular hospital. I don't know how good her insurance is, but she's gonna have to deal with that. But yeah, he's broke. He technically lives in the barracks. He's been I don't know. She kind of admitted I've been kind of throwing good money after bad with this guy, but Anyway, I'm just talking to her about her job now. I don't know. It's her apartment. It's her building. She can basically kick him out whenever she wants. But she's just she's kind of stuck with the idea that with a bunch of complicated feelings, and she kind of doesn't want to leave her work because people like her at work now, and she's enjoyed her job so far. But now she just has a bunch of shit, maybe do a bunch of shit she doesn't want to do. And, you know, she feels like shit at work, and she doesn't want to be there. You know, she's contemplating leaving a job that she really seemed to like when she first started.
Mm. And all because she is getting a child.
Lots of stories I have. Then there's the manager, Aki, that I absolutely hate, and she's the reason I quit, because she causes too much unnecessary stress.
At her work?
Yeah, she has a shitty manager. Which, everyone has a shitty manager. Managers suck. The person who becomes a manager very often is a fucking asshole. Not because they're qualified or anything, but because they're enough of a cunt that they think that they can tell people what to do. That seems to be a big problem of people who actually make up management. Is that they're not people actually making the shit work properly or being good leaders. They're just people who can assign blame and tell people what to do, I guess. Meanwhile, like Gilbert shows up with like a hello, I have a college degree. He's like, okay, well, okay, how about you show up for about 6 months, then fuck off? How about that? maybe you could have a job in HR. We're gonna bring a woman for all the way from Germany, just management, and sit past you. That one's so fucking. That one is still like the weird one that you told me, Gil.
Yeah, and it's happening. I think he's starting today.
Fuck, man. It'd be really funny if he shows up, but like he just against all odds, he doesn't actually speak English. Because like a German traveling to America for must think, oh yeah, well there's like a focus on English education that is a thing that Germans can do, especially, you know, whatever. But then it's just like he just shows up and he only speaks German. He just doesn't know any English. They're stuff they brought him all the way over there. Can't do anything. But he's like getting paid like $111,000 a year.
Just to show up. Yep. I like how some people, like, after they retire, so they stick around, right? And then after they retire, it's like, nope, I don't want to be here anymore. I mean, that's good if you're single. But by the time you, you know... That would not be so obvious anymore.
Yeah.
Or you can be married but no child, right?
Right.
And you can live off your income. But if you have
if
you have a kid and is not 18 yet, then I would still continue working until you're 65.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. But honestly, like, I don't really blame them, because it's like, well, I can retire now and I could actually, like, be around my kid and not work until I'm too old to work anymore.
So our oldest employee is 94.
Him.
Yeah, and she's still here, alive and kicking. She said, I've been working here for 40 years. Fuck me. Oh my god. What a true dedicator. Dedicator. Dedication. That's my god. 40 years? Hunter, would you be working for 40 years? If your job was easygoing.
I mean, yeah, because, like, as long as I get to, like, have something, like, life after work, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
if it's just, like, if it's, like, doing a job for 40 years and then, like, not having anything outside of that. I mean, that's the one thing is that, like, I don't get the ethos is, like, well, you work hard when you're young and then, like, when you're tired. And I just kind of, like, think of the people who just, like, well, I'm 65 years old, and I haven't made any long-term friends outside of work. My life starts now. I'm an old man who has no friends and not a lot of family. Oh, the world's gonna open up to me. I'm gonna feel very much not lonely.
I feel great. Oh man, look how the times changed. And it just, you came out of the freaking, and then like, oh crap, I want to play some tennis now. Oh, my back. That's kind of that's funny and sad at the same time. Oh, look at me. Look what just reeled in.
No, the pet had just said goodnight. She got work tomorrow. That's rough, man. It's good to talk to her again, though. I can imagine, like, a Carl just, like, thinking in his head, why? Why is it good to talk to her again?
Exactly. Why?
Yeah. I like her. She's cool. Actually, you know, I actually don't know, because, like, only bad things seem to happen to her. And she... I think I talk to her because I like that she appreciates that I talk to her. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
It's like there's a weird mutual thing where we just appreciate that we're speaking to each other when shit's going bad or stuff like that. I don't know.
Well, Hunter, for one, you possess more intellectualities out of our asses, and two, you have
I pulled this intellect out of your ass.
And number two, you're more outgoing. I'm outgoing in my own way, okay. But having that mindset as her.
I don't know. Is it weird that like is it weird that if I feel like at like I feel like I'm like with me there's a weird thing where like I can like get to know somebody and be friends with them or like long term like that, but for whatever reason I always have this like feeling, sensation that like there's this point of tension. And it like makes me nervous to be around them. And that tension doesn't go away until they have like cried or told me something fucked up about themselves. You know what I mean? That like the vulnerability of someone going through a low point is like, I don't know how to describe it, but like just, it is
abysmal.
Not dismal. It is wish to speak. How do I describe it?
How do you describe it? Yeah.
There's a tension to normalcy or pretending everything is fine and like, you know, someone is like vulnerable from being at a low point like that, right? And then you can actually like just be honest or more close to them, you know. I feel like people like really don't like it when they hear about your problems, and it's unnerving. And uncomfortable, and they just don't like it, so they avoid people who sort of, you know, talk about bad shit that's happening. Yeah. Okay, fine, fucking whatever, dude, fine. What? This is why I talk to the PETA, not you. Anyway. Anyway, alright, good night, you guys.
Alright.
What are we playing tonight?
I don't know, man.
Oh my god, let's play, Ready or Not. Or Ghost Watchers.
Finicky. I'll you can break the tie. You can. If you have any ideas, then present it this evening. But I'm kind of too tired to actually think about or make plans.
Crusader.
Because. Oh my god.
Okay. Asshole. To be fair to Gil, Stronghold Crusader will be the second thing we do.
And if you guys do that, I'm just gonna stay in WoW, okay? Great.
Okay. Yeah, we'll figure out something. We can figure out something. We're all going to play together tomorrow. But right now, I can't think of anything. I don't want to think about anything right now. All right.
Have you ever played Children of Morta?
No, actually.
What is that?
I haven't.
It's like a co-op RPG game.
Co-op RPG. How much is it?
I don't know. Hold on.
Oh wait, I do remember this. Yes.
Oh, $22, Dan.
I have it. I have it.
Do you play it?
I played a little bit of it. I remember now.
Was it any good?
It is really good.
Game's co-op.
Co-op. I think you can play up to four.
Hmm.
But I never played with four. I just played with my coworker. It's pretty good. I highly recommend it.
All right, then. Maybe that's their next game.
There we go.
$22, though.
Yes.
Yeah, I do not have $22.
Oh, my God, Hunter. No. Let's discuss this tonight.
Yeah, we'll discuss it later. Like I said,
when I get off at 9 p.m. from work.
Okay.
Okay, so let's discuss this tonight, and then we'll before I buy before I gift it, whatever.
I you don't have to do that, but like it, like I'm just like letting you know that like that I that's a factor of whether I'll decide to play. As if like if I have it or if I can't afford to pay for it. I'm sorry. Okay, whatever. We'll talk about this later. All right. Good night, you guys.
Alright. Till tonight.
Rest you.
Oh no. Oh, yes. Hook and pet up with Ben, okay? Because, he's a very lonely, grieving person. It's testimonizing that needs fatal attraction. And Nepeta would be the one and only for him, yes. I mean, you can always go both ways. There's so much charisma, yes, that illuminates a Fen's being, well-being, enough for Nepeta to adore and contrast, yes. Fen is in the PH. So maybe, I guess you could, I guess Nepeta can,
That spell is not...
So, what do you think? I think Chen is in the lead on this one. I think that would be a swell idea. Absolutely. Cowabunga! Alrighty. Quack, 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 a doodle do. Is there a cave of orgs? Ogres? Oh, this mountainside. Oh, I don't remember this place.
It's too far away.
Too far away. I am soloing level 40 plus ogres. Ben's peck peck is my like it.
I can't cast that yet. That spell isn't ready yet.
Oh. Oh, cool. I can dual wield this. Yeah.
That's still recharging.
Yes.
I can't cast that.
I Where are these stupid kobolds?
Oh, I need to get closer.
What? Stupid kobolds. Right, dig.
I'm out of range. I need to get closer.
What? No.
It's too far away.
What? It's too far away.
I'm out of range.
What are you talking about? Oh. Yes, boy. What a hideous fucking what a dumb quest.
I need to target something that's still recharging. Isn't ready yet. I need a target. It's too far away. That's still recharging.
Toot. Hold on. dumbass.
Target something first. I need to get closer. Still recharging.
Hunt hut. What me fat? My lag kit.
That spell isn't ready.
What the fuck? Hold aggro, bitch. Oh my god, you.
That's still recharging. That spell isn't.
Oh, my leg kit, I'm putting you back.
I can't cast that yet.
There's a point. Yay. Shit.
Mokra, go with honor.
Yo! Glad I could help!
Greetings. Be careful.
Blood and thunder. Go with honor.
Come on, Twilo. I'm supposed to support me.
What brings you here? Be careful. What brings you here?
Oh, that's right. I could wear mail.
May the eternal
sun. Oh, yeah.
Hey there. Okie dokie.
Thank you.
Who you be?
Who you be?
Avech.
Hello, man. See ya later.
Ew.
Relax. Be seeing ya. What you want?
What you want?
See ya later.
See you later.
Goodbye.
What can I do for you? Be safe. Strength and honor. For the Horde.
For the Horde. Shit. Let's tame a wolf.
are just the thing for you. Go in peace. What brings you here? May the eternal sun shine.
Thank you.
something special? Well met. Maybe turn the sunshine upon you.
The winds guide you. Walk. What brings you here? Be careful.
How may I aid you? Goodbye. How may I aid you?
Hail. Ancestors watch over you.
It's too far away. Victory lies ahead. We will have justice.
What do you seek? Re- Remember the sun well.
What do you need? Down.
haven't got all day. Beware, our enemies abound.
Hello?
What now? Embrace the shadow. What is it? Beware the living. What now? Talk to me.
Stay away from the
Loktar. Go forth to victory.
Wow.
What you want? Spirits be with you, man. How you doing, man? Be seeing ya. Strength and honor. Cool with honor.
Relax.
Loktar. Go forth to victory. What are you looking for? Strength.
good night, folks.